Let's jump back into some more Pokemon. I know you guys have been sitting there watching me do nothing, really, and explain some technical difficulties and whatnot. If you take bug Pokemon to school, you get to be instantly popular. I bet that's how that works. Someone also wanted the tip jar explained. You click that, you can tip me some money if you want, or you don't have to at all. In fact, I would rather you keep your money for yourself if you're low on money, or donate to charity. Because a charity will be able to use the money a little bit better than I will for people who need it a little bit more than me. At the very least. That's pretty much the explanation. I don't think there's really much else to explain. But that's it. I'm not even sure if I should, like, water gun this thing, like... Hey, that worked out just fine. Critical hit, and it was super effective. Sweet. Yeah, I don't know why your EXP share would be turned off by default. Because I'm pretty sure the two times that I've gone through this area, it came on by default. And apparently we have Foresight, which I don't think I even want. What does this do? Enables a Ghost-type target to be hit by normal and Fighting-type attacks. This also enables an evasive target to be hit. So, in the right hands, this is a good move, but in my hands, it's not good at all. So, I'm gonna forget learning Foresight and just keep what I have. Because I highly doubt that I'll really get anything from that. I'm awesome, thank you. I like when people think I'm awesome. Hearing that I'm awesome is better than hearing that I suck, to be really honest. I think most people are that way, too. Level 12. Alright, we gotta do some shifting around here. I think most people would rather be told that they're awesome instead of they just flat-out suck. So, thank you. I also think we're just about done with this area. As another Pokemon, like... Will it run away if I hop a ledge? I wonder. Not yet. Gotta be very slow, concentrate really hard. Here we go. Got it. Have I had a White Russian? I have had a White Russian. They're pretty good. I actually had a few when I was in Atlanta about 2 weeks ago or so, whenever that was. I wonder if I should catch this. I think I'll catch this for now. And we'll see how it goes. I guess we'll leave the spider out for now to do some damage. I'm awesomely sucky, Scrub. Cool. Thank you for the kind words. So hopefully this bird doesn't kill the stupid spider. I mean, I wouldn't be that upset if it did anyway. But I really just want to try and catch it, because I need a flying Pokemon. But I'm not sure if, like, that stupid water flying Pokemon would be better, or this one. I just didn't want another water Pokemon. Let's try and catch it, sure. Drunk Killing Floor again? I don't really drink a whole lot anymore. I just don't find drinking as enjoyable as I used to. Drinking in moderation is pretty nice, but getting drunk, eh. Not so much about that anymore. This Pokemon, who I don't know how to pronounce its name, either Talo or Tylo, I'm guessing Talo, but I could be wrong, courageously stands its ground against foes, however strong they may be. This gutsy Pokemon will remain defiant even after a loss. On the other hand, it crows loudly if it becomes hungry. No one likes being hungry. What should we name this? Call it Vivek. Well, we already have Vivac. Swellow is better. Seamus get drunk and lost in Atlanta? I did not, actually. Not this time. Name it Madame Zeroni. I have no idea what that's a reference to, but I'm sure it's a reference to something. I'm not naming this Vivek. Call it Bird. B-U-R-D. Call it Sanic. Will I finish Shadows of Mordor? I wouldn't bet on it. Sanic? I'm seeing some Sanics here. Name it Swallow. Will this be posted on YouTube? Probably. Bird. I'm seeing Sanic and Bird, so let's go with this. How about we compromise a little bit? We go with Burf? No, we go with Bird. If this will fit. Eh. Bird Sanic. I think that works. Bird Sanic. How's that? Table, name it Swallow. Madame Zeroni's from the movie Holes. I haven't seen that movie in a very long time. We're going with Bird Sanic. Sure. Miles, because he has two tails. It's a little bit late. I'm sorry. Let's get out of this forest. And let's heal our Pokemon. I was being spied on. This is the Petalburg Recon team checking in. I'm afraid I have to begin with an apology, Ms. Courtney. It's not good news. This mission is a no-go. A little something cropped up and got in the way. Roger that. Got it, will do. I'll continue investigating that energy we detected. Ooh. Look at those short shorts and high boots. She thinks I have promise. That's good. Does anyone know if this will be posted on YouTube? It more than likely will. I just don't know when. Because I still have to get the Resident Evil stuff up, and there's still some more Smash stuff that needs to go up. Oh, this is a trainer. Oops. All hail Bird Sanic, of course. Am I going to set a schedule for streams? I don't know. At this point, it's more or less when I feel like streaming, which will most certainly probably be several times a week, but I don't know when or what days. This is a level 8 Pokemon, and I'm not really liking my chances, so we'll just go back to Kaplipiss. Because I don't want to set a schedule and then like wake up one day and be like, I really don't want to stream, and then, you know, feel inclined to do a stream that might end up being sucky because I'm just not there. But at the same time, it gives people, you know, okay, he's going to be streaming this day, and this day, this week, at this time. So, like, I definitely see the pros and cons to it. Or just mostly the pros. I should probably just be using Tackle. Holy shit, this thing hits hard. I really hope I don't die. It has a full restore, so I'm just going to use a potion after this. Yeah, let's just go ahead and use a nice little potion. This Zigzagoon hits a lot harder than I thought it would. I probably should have done some extra training, but... Don't forget to go left. I'd like to get through the game, like, mostly on my own. My defense just fell, so that sucks. I'd like to get through the game mostly on my own. Because I really don't want to be told, you know, everything that needs to be done. Because I like doing things on my own. Even if I don't have all the information. Like, to be honest, my knowledge with Pokemon games is pretty low. But I'd still rather just like to go through the game on my own. Oh good, Sweet Scent. Bird Sanic grew to level 6, very nice. And I defeated Lady Cindy. Oh my! Live your life as you want, that is great advice. I need to have the bird Pokemon here. Who is almost dead, by the way. I feel like I might need to do just a little bit of grinding somewhere, just to get everyone kind of up to speed. What's up? I like to shout my lungs out, it feels so good. You can have this, so try it out. Use it on a Pokemon and it will learn a move that attacks with its voice. If the move is used several times in a row, it becomes more powerful. Echoed voice. I don't know if that's any good. A word of advice, TM, can be used many times, won't go away, which is definitely a change from the older games, because you can only use a TM once, I'm pretty sure, in like Gen 1 and Gen 2. I don't know when they changed that. I don't know what gen they made it so that TMs could be used a bunch of times. Was it the original White and Black, maybe? I'm not sure. I think it's a relatively new feature for the game, but I don't think it was made in this game. Because I'm pretty sure Let's see, hello, this is the Pretty Petal Flower Shop, spreading flowers throughout the world. Your name is Ciamus. It's a good name. Why wouldn't it be a good name? Do I like to learn about berries? No, I don't really care. But I'm pretty sure it's more of a newer feature, so I wouldn't be surprised if, like, white and black were the original ones. Did Emmy do this border? Emmy did not do this border. I have not used Emmy as an artist in a very long time. I'm trying to be like my big sisters. I'm growing flowers, too. Here you go, it's for you. Hey, I got a Chesto berry. You can plant a berry to grow more berries, which we will probably not be doing. We'll just be ravaging the earth of its berries and never planting them again. I got a Whalmer pail. It's cool. Teach the TM to Zigzagoon. I probably should. That's probably not the worst idea. How many Pokemon games have I played? I've played a lot of them. But just really casually. Like I always say, pretty much after Gen 2, I don't know a whole lot about the game. And even, like, I mess up, like, weaknesses and strengths a whole lot, too. I think I missed something back here as well. I think you can actually go, like, around this house and get something. Oh, there's a Pokemon here. Hold on. Here we go. Got it. I don't even know what it is, but... Who did this border? I believe an artist by the name of Rancake. I'm pretty sure that's who did it. A level 7 Wingull will probably just kill it. Who should I have go out? Well, no one can really do a whole lot of damage. I guess we could send Doge out. Hopefully that Wingull does not have a good water move. Actually, well, I don't even think it'd matter anyway. Just because I have a fire attack doesn't mean I'm a fire Pokemon. I'm still, like, normal and dark, probably, or something like that. Though this move probably will not do a whole lot, so... Oh, it does have a water move. Well, that sucks. This move's probably not going to do a whole lot to it, though. No. I should have assumed that. And I don't have any other moves to really do anything. So, I guess we'll just go with the tried and true Kaplis. Yeah, the layout actually looks really nice. It's not too bad. Definitely did a good job with it. It looks very nice. Okay, so what do we got? We got Tackle. Let's go with Tackle. Hey, there we go. That's a little better. Who would have known that a fire attack will not work that well on a water Pokemon? Who would have known? ...54 points. We got some experience for everybody. Ooh, Birdsanic is already level 7. Aw, wow, everyone's getting levels here. This is great. No one's learning any new moves, though. That's terrible. Fantastic. So Birdsanic's level 7. Still got some more work. I might heal up and do a little bit of grinding in this area. I'm not really happy with the level my Pokemon are right now, so... Maybe a couple more levels, and I think we'd probably be good for the rest of the game, because experience share will just carry us through the entire game. Because the experience share is, like, ridiculous. I don't even know what game they put that into, because I know in, like... I know in the original games you could get an experience share, like, in maybe as early as Gen 1. But you could only give it to one Pokemon, and only that Pokemon would get the experience. I'm pretty sure that's how it worked. But then they changed it in later gens to just give experience to everybody in the party, whether they were used or not. And it's just, it makes everything a lot easier. Like, you don't have to do much grinding at all. As opposed to the early games, like the early gens, I felt like I had to do a lot of grinding in them. To be, like, where I wanted to be at any given time. Super Mario 64 stream soon? I've never even beaten the game, because I'm that bad at it. So I would never expect a Super Mario 64 stream unless you just want to watch someone be bad and quit. Probably 15% through the game. I just cannot play that game. I'm just too bad at it. Anyway, we probably need a potion for Kaplis at least. Just to keep him going nice and nice and strong. Which Pokemon? Capiplus, of course. I'm not really too concerned about the bird, because he's just getting switched out every time anyway. Oh my god, that eyesight. Should I or shouldn't I? Okay, sure, I will battle. Saw me from the... complete opposite side of the screen. Lass Haley. Ooh, there's that table everyone's talking about. Killing Floor stream? I haven't played Killing Floor in a very long time. And I doubt I'll want to play it a whole lot. Because I maxed out, like, I don't even know why I used Peck, but it worked out. I was hoping that that would work. So I was like, oh yeah, Peck's gonna be super effective. Bird Sanic, level 8. The dream. He got no special defense, but hey, 2 health, 2 speed, sure. He got a lot of experience for that. Shroomish? No. We'll keep battling. The question is, can I get another Peck off and kill it in one shot? Yeah, I mean, I'm really not like... Oh god, this could be bad. Sun Spore? Eh, I can just take it out. Like, I'm really not looking to improve my knowledge as someone who plays Pokemon. I'm just looking to play it for funsies. And, like, I really don't care how much damage something does, as long as it does damage. And then from there, I'll be like, okay, this move doesn't do any damage. I should probably switch to a different Pokemon, or, you know. Who should we bring out? How about this guy? I'm just here to play the game, have some fun with it, and interact with chat. Because this is a game that just lets me interact with chat a little bit easier. Because there's not a whole lot going on. There's not a whole lot that I need to be paying attention to, or really be thinking about. So this is one of those just easy to play games where I can just play through it, make progress, look at the chat. And that's pretty much that. Unfortunately, I'm slowly losing health over and over. So here's what we're gonna do, boys. We're gonna potion. We only have 6 left. What do these berries do? 10 HP and then that. Okay, let's just use a potion. I know I'm paralyzed, but I'm hoping that doesn't really matter a whole lot. Sif is holding something again. We'll have to check that. Dark Souls stream? Probably not anytime soon. I'm pretty Dark Souls'd out. The Shroomus is... They're just wreaking havoc on me. Alright, if this doesn't kill it, I'm just switching Pokemon. Please kill it. This should kill it. We're good. Peggle stream, maybe? I'm pretty peggled out as well. Unless there is, like, some new Peggle 2 DLC or something. Bird Sanic is level 9. Quick attack for Bird Sanic, sweet. Capiplus, level 13. Getting carried by the EXP share. I love it. Maybe I shouldn't have battled. Give me your money. See you later. So Bird Sanic is level 9-ish, which is great, I think. Fantastic. We'll just keep it there. Everyone's paralyzed. Everyone is paralyzed. Let me check my TM. Would this TM be any good? Like, I'm probably not going to use it on anyone else anyway. So let's use it on Sif. And they don't disappear anyway, so it, like, really doesn't matter. What should be forgotten? Probably Growl. Or Tail Whip. Let's get rid of... I'm probably never going to use either of those two, so whatever. Does the Vita even have a capture card? There's a company that does capture cards for some of the handheld devices, and I'm pretty sure the Vita is one of them. I'm pretty sure the same company that I got my DS capture card from does, like, Vita and PSP capture cards, maybe? We also gotta get this item. We had a potion. Sif had a potion. I'm pretty sure they also do some other handheld stuff. Oh, we have a double battle coming up here. Who should I have out? Let's have Sif and Vivac. Probably the two worst Pokemon I own. Let's see what they can do. Yeah, I'm not such a big fan of Minecraft to begin with. Like, I'll play it, but it's not a game that's for me, I think. Alright, so what do we got here? We got Echoed Voice, Stupid Zigzagoon. Let's go ahead and take out the... Oh my god, that close-up. That was amazing.